Yes. If you love to praise
his name,
then you are one of his.
Yes.
Somebody say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Comfort ye. Comfort ye, my people, said the Lord.
Yes.
Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is what?
Accomplished.
Her warfare is accomplished. Now, this is very important to know what God is saying here unto you and I. You have become a precious jewel. You have become one of his children.
Yeah.
The scripture says, if any man is in Christ Jesus, yeah, he is a new creature.
Hallelujah.
Is that right?
That's right.
All things pass away.
Uh-huh.
Pass away. In our language in Liberia, when someone say the person passed away, then they are dead. Is that right?
Yes.
I don't know what it is. It's common in America, but when an African man or African woman tell you that this person passed away, they're talking about that person is dead.
No.
So the scripture is saying your old thing passed away. Your old lifestyle has passed away. It's dead.
Yes.
Don't go by digging out what is dead. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The scripture said, if any man is in Christ Jesus, he's a new creature. Is that right?
That's right.
Old thing what? Pass away and everything become what? Mm-hmm. New. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So God is saying here, you have become my people because your old lifestyle has been killed.
Amen.
Your old lifestyle has been thinking away. If a man is in Christ Jesus, he's a new creature. All things pass away and everything become new. Say, neighbor,
neighbor.
I am a child of God.
So
God is saying here, saying you embrace him to be your savior.
Yes. Right.
Saying you embrace him to be your deliverer. You know of his attribute. You know what he is capable of doing. You know he's a God that never failed. You know he's a God that never lost a single battle. Is that right?
Yeah.
You know that the devil may be mighty, but God is almighty. Yeah. Somebody shouts to glory. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah, God is all. He's almighty. You have to carry that in your mind that, yes, my God is powerful. Devil, yeah, no matter how mighty you think you are, my God is almighty. Witchcraft, no matter how powerful you think you are, my God is almighty. Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. My
God is
almighty. You got to think that with you every time as a remembrance, because some of the tools that the devil uses is forgetfulness.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes in the heat of the battle, we forget.
Yeah.
We forget to use the weapon that we have. Is that right? Sometimes in the midst of it all, the affliction, the devil tried to distract us from using the proper weapons.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Have you ever been there?
Yeah.
Have you ever been there? Sometimes the devil tried to distract us from using the proper weapons against him.
Amen.
So he distracts us. He afflict us though in a way that we lost our thinking ability. We start to petrify ourselves. Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to God. But you have to remind yourself every day that I am serving an almighty God.
That's right. Amen.
Is that right? I'm serving an almighty God that loves me and cares about me. He cares about me so much that he sent his only begotten son to die for me. And if he can send his son to die for me, what else he cannot do for me? Somebody shall say hallelujah. If God can send his only begotten son to die on your behalf, what else he cannot do for you? Somebody shall say praise the Lord. For God so loved the world that He gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. You have to remind yourself each and every day, because the Bible says we are like sheep before the slaughter. We are being killed all day long. The enemies do not have to take gun to point at you and shoot at you before you know that you're going to die.
All right.
Do not have to come after you with a sword.
Right.
But the mouth, the tongue of a man is deadly.
Yes.
Man can kill you with their tongue. Yes. They can tag you with name. Somebody say praise the Lord. They can laugh on you. My goodness. They can gossip about you.
Yes.
They can bite. Come on. Is there anybody here that understands where we're going?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Words are hurtful.
Yes.
Words are hurtful. Somebody,
yes.
Especially so, words that are not true are hurtful.
Yes.
Somebody say praise the Lord.
And
not only words that are lies, but sometimes people that you trust with your feeling,
right.
People that you trust with your problem,
yes.
People that you trust, you thought they would bite you, or they can spit on your secret, and it can be hurtful.
Yes.
Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So as a child of God, the Bible says, being righteous, carry persecutions. Sometimes your righteousness, your righteous ways of walking, your righteous way of talking, your righteous way of taking care of yourself, you refuse to hang out with the Joneses because you are protecting something valuable. You are protecting your value. You are protecting your integrity. You are protecting your family name. You are protecting, my goodness, the power of the servant, the name that God gave you. You refuse to put Jesus to an open shame. Say you cannot hang out with those that you used to hang out with. Say you cannot talk the way you used to talk. Say you cannot walk the way you used to walk. Somebody will rise up against you.
That's right.
Somebody will rise up against you. But as you know your relationship with God, you do not want for anything to come between you and God. So you stand your ground, and somebody will hit you for it. Somebody shouts and praise the Lord. So God said yes. See, those are the value that God is looking for in you and I. Those are the value that he saw in Job. Even when his three friends came to him, even when his wife came to him and told him, curse God and die, he refused to give up his integrity. He refused to give up his value. Somebody shouts and praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So Job 28:28 says, the fear of God is wisdom. Keeping yourself of evil is understanding. If you have those two things, it can help you to keep your value. It can help you to keep your integrity. It can help you to stand your ground, knowing that you are not alone. Say, neighbor, you are never alone. Knowing that you are not alone. Yes. That everywhere you go, Jesus has promised to be with you always, even until the end of the world. Because you are not of yourself anymore. You don't belong to the Jews anymore. You don't belong to your secret sorority anymore. You don't belong to your secret society anymore. You don't belong, come on now, you don't belong to any group of people, but you know that you belong to God. Say, neighbor, you belong to God. So you know that you belong to God in the name of Jesus. It is good to know where you belong. It is good to know your address. Somebody shall say hallelujah. It is good to know your address. It is good to know that you are having a good relationship with God. It is good to know from whom you belong to. Somebody shall say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Yes.
It is good to know who your daddy is. Can I preach to you now? It is good to know who your daddy is. Because we all here have our relatives. When we read the Lord's Prayer, we say our Father. Is that right? So no matter where you're from, whether you are American or Liberian, whether you are black or white, Spanish, you and I are brothers and sisters. And because when we all have the same Father, we call on Him our Father. Is that right? Our Father which art in heaven. Holy or hallowed be your name. So now. So God reveal all those things to us, to know to whom we belong, to know where our address lies. We have become royal priesthood. You have become princess and prince in the kingdom of God. Somebody shall say hallelujah. You have become heard with Christ. Somebody say glory to God. So you got to remind yourself every day who you are in the Lord. Because when you do so, then if you can know that you belong to God, just imagine what God knows of you. Hallelujah. Well, just imagine what God knows of you. You are making an effort to serve Him. You are making an effort to praise Him. You are making an effort to present your body as a living sacrifice unto Him. Is that right? You refuse to be conformed to this word. You are going on every day with a renewed mind. Is that right? You are walking every day with a renewed mind. My mind has been renewed because I belong to Christ. I have a mind in me that is in Christ Jesus. Do I have a witness here? I have this mind in me that is in Christ Jesus. I refuse to follow the things of the world. I refuse to follow the things of the world. You can go with that in your heart, in your spirit, and in your mind, and you remind God every day, I belong to you, Lord. I am your child. I am your son. That God is coming back to you, speaking to you. Say, come for ye, my people. Holy Ghost, come for ye, my people. Holy angels, come for ye, my people. Say, your God, speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished. Your warfare is accomplished. In other words, God is saying here, the buck stop here with me. Hallelujah. You don't have to fight your own fight anymore. Your physical warfare is accomplished. Your spiritual warfare is accomplished. Hallelujah. Vengeance belong to me. Say the Lord. Somebody say hallelujah. You don't have to fight your own fight anymore. Somebody say glory to God. In other words, God is saying here that since you have embraced Him to be His, since you are embracing to be your God and your Lord and your Savior and your all in all, He is saying to you this morning, you don't have to fight your own fight anymore. Say, neighbor, you don't have to fight. Oh, who the Lord is talking to here? You don't have to fight your own fight anymore. Somebody say glory to God. In other words, I am taking over from now on. Say, neighbor, God is taking over from now on. In the name of Jesus. Oh, come on. Do not have a witness here. God is taking over from now on. In the name of Jesus. No matter what the warfare may be, it may be against sickness or disease. Oh yes, it may be against an unseen enemy. It may be against spiritual demons. Oh glory to God. It may be against the Joneses. Oh my goodness, the federal government. It may be against any power. God is saying here, your part of the warfare is accomplished. When God says it's accomplished, means it's finished. Is that right? I'm preaching to you. I'm prophesying to you now. I know what the Holy Ghost is sin. He's saying that your warfare now is accomplished. You don't have to fight your own fight anymore. Is that right? Oh yes, then you got to trust him now. Say, neighbor, you got to trust him now. Because God is speaking. Hallelujah. That it both stop with him now. Not with you anymore. Is that right? So glory to God. So the Bible says unto us, your warfare is accomplished. Oh yes. Not only your warfare that is accomplished. Yes. That your iniquity has been pardoned. In other words, your sin has been forgiven. Somebody say glory to God. Your sin has been forgiven. The reproach of Egypt have been removed from you. Can I have a head here? The reproach of Egypt has been removed. Are you glad that God has forgiven your sin? Are you glad that God has removed the reproach of Egypt off of you? Are you glad that God has removed the stumbling blocks that were between you and him? Are you glad that he has removed the stumbling blocks that were between you and him? Are you glad that he can speak to you freely? Are you glad that you can speak to him freely? That all the obstacles have been removed. Somebody say glory to God. The obstacles have been removed. In other words, you are welcome now to walk in the throne room with him. You are welcome now to walk in the throne room and talk to him face to face and cry to him hallelujah and call him, you are my father, and he will say, you are my child. Somebody try to say hallelujah. In the throne room now and talk to him face to face. Can no devil stop you from going to him? Somebody say hallelujah. Can no devil stop you from going to him? Oh, glory to God. Can no obstacles stop you from speaking to him? Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. That's why Jesus stood up in Matthew 28 and 11. Come on unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus said, enter into my covenant. My covenant of rest. Say, neighbor, the covenant of rest is for you. Hallelujah. Come on, come to me. The covenant of rest is for you. Come on to me, all ye that labor and heavy laden. And Jesus is speaking. I will give you rest. Say, neighbor, the covenant of rest belongs to you. Cause you are somebody in Christ Jesus. Cause you have been called by the name of God Almighty. If my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and quake their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and hear their land. Send me either the covenants, the covenants, God's covenants, arrest. You enter the room, enter into the throne room, enter into his rest. The covenant of God belongs to you. The Bible says, walk into the throne room. Boldly. Hallelujah. You can walk now boldly before the throne of God. Hallelujah. And proclaim your sonship. You can proclaim
being a daughter, your daughtership. You can proclaim being a servant. You can tell the devil, I am the servant of Jesus Christ. Can you say that? Of Jesus Christ. Devil, flee from me. Sickness, flee from me. Disease, flee from me. Devil, flee from me. The servant of Jesus Christ. Say yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Enter his rest. Hallelujah. A covenant of rest. You do not have to carry on your own loads anymore. I'm prophesying to you. The Holy Ghost telling me to tell you, you don't have to worry about you carrying your own burdens. Upon him. Is that what the Bible says? Cast your cares upon him, for he careth for you. Say, neighbor, God cares for you. Oh, put your hands together. He cares for you. In the name of Jesus. Yes. So he's saying,
that's right,
unto you, you and I enter into his covenant of rest. Is that right? In the name of Jesus, your sickness have been removed. Your iniquity have been removed. Is that right? The Bible says, if one of you is sick, call on the elders of the church. Let them lay hands upon you, and when they pray for you, you will be healed, and your sickness will be dismissed, and your sin will be removed. Now, if man, the prayer of man, can deliver you from your sin, if the prayer of man, can I have a hand here? If a prayer of man can deliver you from your sin, if a prayer of man can deliver you from your sickness, now God himself is saying unto you, the warfare has been accomplished. God himself is saying unto you, your sin has been pardoned. Hallelujah. Your sin has been pardoned. That means that your sickness has been removed. Your disease has been dismissed. Your enemies have been defeated. Your warfare, hallelujah, your enemies have been defeated. Do I have a witness here? Do I have a witness here? Your enemies have been defeated. Therefore, God says, the voice of him that cried in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert the highway for our God. Hallelujah. I'm making straight the highway of our God. Unto you this morning, you don't understand. Hallelujah. Are you with me in the spiritual realm? God commended me. Hallelujah. He commended me. Yes. To cry in the wilderness, to prepare for him. Is that right? The way of the Lord. To live straight in the desert. A highway for him, hallelujah, to come. He told me to tell you that when he comes, as I speak preach the word to you. As you receive his word, if you believe, say neighbor, the Bible says, hallelujah, say neighbor, the Holy Ghost says, if you believe, hallelujah, that God is visiting you, hallelujah, if you believe that God is visiting you this morning, this hour, if you believe that God is visiting you at this moment, if you believe that God is talking to you through his servant at this hour, every valley before you shall be exalted. Shall be made low in your life. The cracking shall be made straight in your favor. The rough places shall be made smooth in your favor. Say, neighbor, the Holy Ghost says, God is visiting your home. God is visiting your family. The Holy Ghost says, if you believe, everybody before you, hallelujah, you will be exalted, hallelujah. Every mountain and hills before you shall be made low. Every crooked place, hallelujah, before you shall be made straight, hallelujah. Every rough place, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Every work, every rough place shall be made clean. Every rough place, hallelujah. Because God is taking over your warfare. Come on, hallelujah. Shake me with somebody. Say, neighbor, God, this God that you and I said, is taking over your warfare. This God. Now you and I said, in the name of Jesus, is taking over your worries, is taking over your conditions. This God, Jehovah God, Jehovah Rapha, now you and I said, is taking over your sickness. He will be a light unto you, a healer to your body. Praise the name, glorify it, glorify the name, a believer in the house. And there's a believer in the house. And there's a believer in the house.
Who the Lord talking to this afternoon?
Your victory is sure. Who the Lord talking to here?
Yes, your victory is sure. My God, my God, my God, my God. Did you say, yet though my mother and my father forsake me, the Lord would pick me up.
Hallelujah.
The Lord. Your warfare is over. Your warfare is over. You've been waiting too long. You've been crying too long. Your warfare is over. Is that right? If you believe the Lord, keep on praising Him. If you believe the word, keep on praising Him. If you believe the word, keep on glorifying Him. If you believe the word, keep on worshiping Him. Your victory is sure. Your victory is sure. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Your victory is sure. Blessed holy man. You've been waiting. You've been waiting too long. You've been waiting. You've been waiting too long. You've been waiting too long. You've been through. You've been through hard trials. You've been through some loneliness. You've been through some lonely days. Hallelujah. God says, your victory is sure. It is the word of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Come on, bless the holy name. Hallelujah. Your victory is sure. You've been waiting too long. You've been waiting too long. Now is your time. The Bible says, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, has thou not known? Has thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord